Welcome back. How was your trip to Arlington? Good. Did you have a chance to visit any of the shops? Oh, one of my favorites. I imagine you were likely roped into a purchase or two. I thought so. Mabel can be quite overbearing. Or persistent, let's say. So, what did you end up with? A dragon egg, really? Yes, I'd love to have a look if you don't mind. Oh, wow. It's an excellent choice. She'll be a great travel companion for you. Yes. How long until she hatches? Oh, that's very exciting. Mm-hmm. As soon as she hatches, you should be sure to pay another visit to Mabel at the menagerie so she can provide a nice checkup to just ensure that she's fully healthy and everything is in order. Mm-hmm. Mabel may seem a tad scatterbrained, but she absolutely knows what she's talking about when it comes to her creatures. She's very experienced. She used to be a world traveler, actually. Did she tell you about that at all? I thought not. She tends to go off on tangents, so anything relating too closely to reality is usually not even in her realm of attention whatsoever. But it's actually quite an interesting little bit of a story, if you'd like to hear. She used to have no home and simply spent all of her days and nights traveling the world in search of little creatures in need of help and care. It used to be just a small little troop. It was actually a well-known sight around the world to see little Mabel with a small Fluffin perched on her shoulder, a wee Verity Vitam flying above, baby Wimrost trailing close behind on foot. She would have a few eggs strapped into her belt, a baldric full of healing potions, a bag stuffed to the brim with flasks of medicines, ointments, bandaging supplies, milk, feed. You get the idea. She would wander about helping creatures in need and adopting any who found themselves alone in the world, and with that, her pack slowly grew larger and larger and larger until it was an entire herd, really. But at that point, travel was no longer exactly practical. I'm sure you can imagine that traveling around the world with so many creatures, it eventually becomes impossible to ensure the safety of every last one of them. So, unable to bear the thought of leaving a single one behind, Mabel, she gave up her life traveling the world and instead settled down in little old Harpington with all of her creatures and started up her menagerie. So now whenever anyone finds a lost little creature in need, they know exactly where to take them. Mm-hmm. And she only finds the very best homes for all of her little ones. So the fact that she entrusted you with a dragon egg says quite a lot of her impression of you. Mm-hmm. Well, today is the day that I read through and post up the various notices that villagers and shopkeepers have sent in throughout the week, so if you don't happen to have any more pressing matters to deal with, you're more than welcome to have a seat and take a look through them with me. It can be quite entertaining. Of course, go ahead, have a seat. Is there anything I can get you to drink? Just to set that on the table for you whenever you're ready for it. And it's a bit cold in here. Would you like a blanket? Of course.
Let's see. Let's turn around and get something.
Here we go. There you are. Babblebrook is somewhat of a hub around here. Many, many people of all varieties from all around the world passing through all the time. So if there's any sort of message that you want to garner as much attention towards as possible, here's the place to send it. We post them all up just over here if you'd ever like to take a look. Well, we post most of them at least. I have to take a look through all of them first to make sure that none of them pose any danger to anyone in particular, you might be surprised how many of the notices we receive are simply calling for the demise of one's nemesis. But many of them, most of them, I would say, are helpful notices about upcoming festivals, fairs, feasts, interesting items for sale, apprenticeships, that sort of thing. It's quite useful. So let's see what we have this week. Our first one comes along with a helpful illustration. Let's see what this is about. Oh no. Lost fairy horse. Last sighted 3 nights ago on the outskirts of the Glenham Forest heading north. Responds to name when called Rudder Scumps. That's an excellent name, isn't it? Fond of treats, sprinkles of sugar, thimbles of oats, spoonfuls of applesauce. Reward if found, a freshly baked sourdough loaf, 14 leprosia blossoms, and endless thanks. Signed, Oliver Brown of Falkirk. Well, that one will certainly be going up. I hope he's able to find her. Have you seen a fairy horse before? They're about the size of a plum, so pretty easy to lose track of, unfortunately, but to their advantage, they can fly and have an excellent sense of direction. So, hopefully, little Rudder Scumps may not be lost at home. Maybe just going for an adventure in pursuit of treats, and we'll turn back up for Oliver before too long. But along your travels, be sure to keep an eye out for a little fairy horse like this one. Looks like he says she is white with mottled gray and lavender wings. Alright, that is going to go in the be sure to hang up pile. I'll be sure to commit this to memory as well, just in case I happen to see her out in the garden. I'd imagine she would be attracted to the fruits that we have growing out there. Fairy horses are always fond of sweets. Let's see what we have next. This one seems to be an advertisement. Harbington Haberdashery, a great place. For sale at Harbington Haberdashery. Those shades sound beautiful. I once actually had a gown tailor-made at Harbington Haberdashery. They're very kind there. It was a deep emerald green gown with bell sleeves lined in white lace. Mm-hmm. I passed it down to my younger sister and she's very fond of it. So, that one should be going up. The All Hallows Eve Festival. They say there is lantern lighting, apple bobbing, clever tricks and tasty treats, dancing and drinking around the bonfire. Arrive in disguise and bring a special dish for the feast. Everyone is invited. Looks like someone has scrawled except Peter. Wonder what he did. Sundown to sun up in the Brightwell cornfields north of Lancaster. This is great fun every year. Everyone arrives in costume. People come from all over. People of all varieties bring their homemade dishes. It's so fun to try everybody's cooking. People of all types also come to sell their wares. All of these fun activities. I definitely recommend it. Poor Peter. Let's see. Next up. Looking for a wife. This type of notice is another one of our most common. Alright. Let's see what he has to say. Greetings, fine young maidens of Harbington. 32 years, with a tolerable face and an even more tolerable personality. I have a perfect cat. He is truly excellent. You would not understand unless you had met him. I'm in search of a lady to wed and act as enjoyable company for my cat while I am out of farming and unable to give him the love he rightly deserves. If intrigued, please send a letter to Bennett at Falkirk Farms, or visit in person if you would like to become acquainted with my cat before committing. He excitedly awaits your arrival. And the cat is pictured here on the back, lovingly hand-drawn, even in color. Well, that's sweet. You like cats, don't you? Would you like me to send a letter to Bennett on your behalf? All right, suit yourself. I just wanted to give you an opportunity before I post it up, and you'll have all of Harbington and more to compete with. Alright. Let's see. Plagued by ill luck. I have the cure. Visit the dark alleyway behind Nutmeg Market in Harbington Square at 12:30 to remedy all your troubles. Let's not include. Next. Oh. Farmhouse for sale. In the lower end of Lancaster, on Fenfoss River, and known by the name of Blackwell's Nest. Upwards of 2,000 acres, and is equal to any on the river for its fertility of soil and productive crops. Signed, Thomas Malcolm. Oh, wow. What a beautiful home. He doesn't mention the cost. I'm sure he must be asking quite a lot. The Fenfoss River is remarkable. And he's right that the crops from around there are excellent. That's a nice chimney. Wooden door. Brick. Some stepping stones out front. And right on the seeking hasty transport from Harbington to Lancaster, offering half a bottle of particularly delicious mead and good company in exchange for a ride to Lancaster by the end of the month. Send a raven to 37 Bryman Street in Harbington, addressed to Ermintrude. It's a shame your dragon isn't hatched and grown yet. You'd be able to help Ermintrude out. Dragon transport is as fast as it gets, aside from transportation spells, which are incredibly expensive and very risky. Not that flying a dragon isn't risky as well, but I suppose they're just risky in different ways, aren't they? Have you been to Lancaster before? Another place I would recommend visiting, of course. The like hustling, bustling city. Boredom plagued barkeep. If one finds themselves idle, I extend a humble invitation to join in a game of chess at the Night Owl Tavern in Harbington Square. If you ever find yourself in the area, the Night Owl Tavern is wonderful. It tends to be very peaceful there. They have warm, roaring fireplaces, delicious drinks, especially the cider, soft, comfortable seats with rich, soft fur blankets, big wooden tables with games to play, and a particularly talented lute player. It's a lot of fun. It's one of my favorite spots in the autumn and the winter. I'd be happy to bring you there sometime. It's not too far of a journey. This is to forewarn all persons from trading with my wife, Elizabeth Hardy. as she has absconded my bed and board without any just cause or provocation, I am determined not to pay any debts of her contracting. Signed, Casper Hardy. And Casper has even lovingly included this oh so flattering illustration of his dear Elizabeth. Possession of Humphrey Hilligan on the 23rd day of September, one gray goose, whilst he was innocently and laboriously in search of gravel for the crop of said goose. Whoever will return said goose or provide any information that will lead to the recovery of said goose shall be liberally rewarded. Signed, Humphrey Hilligan of Agrimar. Even included illustration. Unfortunately, being Agrimar, I would not be at all surprised if it was stolen instead of lost or strayed. Well, I hope that they are reunited, poor Humphrey. Ah, pumpkin harvest. Come choose your splats of ooey-gooey pumpkin pulp at your rowdy neighbor's, no thank you, farming fields southeast of Harpington. This pumpkin patch is very beautiful. I was just there the other day. It's a small clearing surrounded by tall trees with leaves of many shades of gold, amber, scarlet, and burgundy. There's a gentle stream nearby that you can just barely hear. Yes, I was there to pick up a few pumpkins to make roasted seeds and pumpkin pies for the guests. It's a great spot. But apparently I'm doing it all wrong. The thing to do seems to be to throw the pulp at people. I'm out of the know. Panther teeth for basilisk scales. Basilisk scales will be taken in exchange for Sir Panther teeth. At Will's Creek, 5 miles below Grenfleur, at the rate of one pouch of scales for one burlap of teeth. That is a very generous trade. They must be in quite urgent need of those scales. Basilisk scales are many varieties of healing potions. That's unfortunate. There looks to be one left. This is from the crown. Have you ever seen one of these before? They're incredibly rare. I've only ever seen one other, and that was when they announced the passing of the king. Oh. By order of the crown, a hefty reward offered to any peasant providing information as to the whereabouts and activities of the roguish beldams and suspected accomplice. If betruded sight doth not approach, the hag may not be seized. Blessed be the queen, may long she reign. And it looks like they have kindly enclosed a pair of sketches of said beldams and accomplice. Oh. Well, that could be anyone. Now couldn't it? plenty of people wear iridescent feather shoulder pads and skulls mounted on their chests now, don't they? Of course. And this other one too. This could be absolutely anyone. An idea just came to me simply from nowhere. Something that could be quite fun. What if I gave you a makeover? Doesn't that sound just riveting? No. Well, you see, the thing is, the Queen's Guard, they observed you consulting with Nightshade. You must have been spotted as they were making their rounds in the forest, and they're distributing a sketch of your exact likeness. You certainly have a distinctive look with your hair and your outfit and all, but I don't want you to worry. There's absolutely nothing to be afraid of. Just sit back, and I'm going to take care of everything. I'm going to make sure that you become completely unrecognizable, alright? It'll be fun. I can see it already. You're bold. Who has seen this absurdly accurate sketch? I mean, truly, how did they manage this? Some great line work here. And incredible shading. A ways back, Nightshade, she gifted me a few drops of an invisibility potion that I hadn't had any use for. So it has to be around here. Somewhere. Must have tucked it away. Let's see. Here we are. Just take a drop of this, and you will be completely undetectable. I'll be wearing this ring, so I will be the only one that can see you, but to anyone else, I'll simply be fussing with the air like a mad woman. Great. So, let's see exactly what we can change. Shall we begin with your hair? Need to drastically change the silhouette, so I'll be cutting off quite a bit if that's alright. Just going to start at the bottom. The front. And marking my way. Don't worry, I'll make sure it's even. I have an eye for these kind of precise things, I promise. Precision is crucial when you have so many customers who like things just so. Particularly our elven guests. They have a taste for the finer things, definitely. And like their bedding to be flawlessly neat and crisp. Their clothes folded. Just makes bulk of it is cut neatly just around your shoulders. Now I'm just going to trim up just around your face so it frames nicely. That should do the trick. We'll also need to change the color. A good trick for that is some ground up hickamore root mixed with water. Creates a nice pigment. Can stain the hair. It'll deepen the color quite a bit. So we'll just need to mix that up. The consistency. Just be applying this all throughout your hair. Okay. It's going to deepen the color quite a lot. And possibly redden it a bit. Sort of a deep mahogany shade. I think will look very nice on you. Sorry that you got roped into all of this. You were just a nice, productive trip, and that's ended up with the crown after you. The conspiracy of witchcraft is considered a fairly serious crime. Although, the Queen's Guard, I'm sure even the Queen herself, make use of palace services. They act under the pretense of opposing dark magic on moral grounds to protect. Looks like they've sketched you looking a bit rugged with some charcoal and dirt smudged about your face, so I'll have to make sure you look perfectly clean cut. should do it. Let's also change your coat, shall we? That's another thing included in this sketch. I have quite a few that previous guests have accidentally left behind, so I should be able to find some of these. I have this gorgeous red wool cloak that looks stunning. Colder out, that would be nice. What do you think of this one? It is a bit of a unique pattern, isn't it? Normally it would be a positive, but not in this case, unfortunately. Really up to you. Which one would you like? Alright. So, there you are. And the lower half of your face is pretty distinctive, so I need to grab a scarf that helps cover that. This one should go with the coat you selected. Should do the trick, and I'll also try to pull some hair down over your face. Try to hide as much of your facial features as possible. In any other situation, that would sound quite cruel, wouldn't it? But for now, it's simply. Here we are. The potion should be wearing off just about now, which is perfect timing because you are looking entirely unrecognizable, if I do say so myself. But just to stay safe, I would still recommend lying low for a bit. The guards are clearly still on high alert if that notice was just sent out. They should be heading back to Lancaster. You know, as soon as the coast is clear.